Hi everyone, today let's discuss one of the medications, Bimatoprost. Bimatoprost is a prostamide. We can observe the suffix prost within the name of this drug, which indicates that this drug acts like prostaglandins. Bimatoprost can be given to those who have an elevated intraocular pressure, commonly known as IOP. This intraocular pressure is very important, and when it is excessively increased, it may produce high pressure in the anterior chamber of the eye, resulting in eye pain and even loss of vision. So it is very essential to treat the raised levels of intraocular pressure. We can observe an elevation in this IOP in a few conditions like open angle glaucoma. In this condition, IOP is increased due to a reduced outflow of aqueous humor. Aqueous humor acts as a lubricant in the anterior chamber of the eye. Normally, it is drained out of the eye through the canal of sclerm. However, in the people with glaucoma, this outflow is reduced, resulting in elevated levels of intraocular pressure. In such conditions, Bimatoprost can be given to reduce IOP. Another condition is the ocular hypertension, which is associated with an increase in the IOP. Here again, Bimatoprost is mainly used to reduce intraocular pressure. This medication is available as an ophthalmic solution. It is well known under the brand name LUMIGAN. It is available in two strengths, 0.01% and 0.03%. Once administered, Bimatoprost can reduce the intraocular pressure after 4 hours, and it can extend the duration of its action up to 12 hours. However, Bimatoprost is given once daily in order to reduce intraocular pressure. This medication can be combined with other ophthalmic solutions, but there should be at least a 5 minutes gap between their administrations. Another clinical use is in the treatment of hypotrichosis of eyelashes. This is a condition of decreased eyelash growth. Bimatoprost can stimulate the melanocytes, thereby increasing the eyelash growth. For this purpose, it can be given at a concentration of 0.03%. Now let's see the precautions with this medication. The use of Bimatoprost can produce some pigmentation, particularly at the eye. It can produce pigmentation on the iris, eyelids, and eyelashes. On the iris, we can observe brown pigments which are circularly developed. On the eyelid as well as the eyelashes, brown discoloration can be observed. This pigmentation on the eyelids and eyelashes is reversible. By stopping the use of Bimatoprost, this pigmentation can be restored. But for the iris, this pigmentation is irreversible and cannot be restored even by stopping Bimatoprost. Even though pigmentation is not harmful, caution should be taken to check for any decrease in ocular activity with long-term use of Bimatoprost. Similarly, this drug can cause some eyelash changes. Particularly, it can increase the eyelash length as well as the thickness. It can also increase their number. These effects are unwanted when this drug is intended for the treatment of open angular glaucoma or ocular hypertension. Prostaglandin analogs like Bimatoprost can increase the risk of intraocular inflammation. So in ocular inflammation disorders like uveitis, Bimatoprost should be carefully used. Bimatoprost can produce macular edema. So for people with a risk of macular edema, this drug should be carefully given. Similarly, care should be taken for the people who have torn lens capsules as well as artificial lens implants. This Bimatoprost ophthalmic solution contains preservatives like benzalkonium chloride, which may interact with contact lenses. Therefore, before administration, the contact lens should be removed. They can be placed again into the eye after at least 15 minutes of administration of Bimatoprost to avoid this interaction. While using Bimatoprost, contamination of the tip should be avoided. Contamination of the solution may lead to the development of bacterial infections such as bacterial keratitis in the people. Bimatoprost reduces intraocular pressure. Normally, this drug can be given in two strengths, either 0.01% or 0.03%. It is given once daily in order to reduce intraocular pressure. However, with an increased number of doses, we can observe an opposite effect. With an increased number of doses, the effect of Bimatoprost can be reduced. A similar effect can be observed when combined with other prostaglandin analogs such as latanoprost. Therefore, it is better to avoid them while using bimatoprost. Now, let's see the side effects of bimatoprost. This drug mainly produces side effects related to the eye. The common side effect is the redness of the eye, which can be observed after administration. It can even produce some eye irritation as well as eye pain. In a few people, it can produce itchy eyes and blurred vision. Another important side effect is the discoloration of the eyelashes, eyelids, and even skin. Now let's see how this drug acts. Bimatoprost mainly acts on the eye. Within the eye, aqueous humor is responsible for lubrication of the lens. However, when its levels are elevated, it produces some high pressure within the anterior chamber. This can produce pain as well as discomfort in the eye. If it is left untreated, it may lead to blurred vision and even loss of vision. Bimatoprost is selectively accumulated within the anterior chamber, where it increases the outflow of aqueous humor. Due to the increased outflow of aqueous humor, the intraocular pressure is reduced. This relieves the symptoms of both open angle glaucoma and ocular hypertension. How it is given? This drug is available as an ophthalmic solution with two strengths of 0.01% and 0.03%. In the first concentration, each 1 ml contains 0.1 mg of bimatoprost, and in the second concentration, each 1 ml contains 0.3 mg of bimatoprost. The right concentration required for use depends on the patient's conditions and clinical uses. For the reduction of intraocular pressure, the dose of bimatoprost is given as one drop given once daily. It should be remembered that this drug should not be given more than one drop and more than once daily. So that's all about this medication, bimatoprost. It is a prostaglandin analog that acts as prostaglandin, thereby increasing the drainage of aqueous humor and resulting in a reduction of intraocular pressure. It can be used in conditions like open angle glaucoma as well as ocular hypertension. It can also increase the growth of eyelashes when applied topically. This bimatoprost can produce changes in the eyelashes, eyelids, and iris. It can produce some brown pigmentation. When it is combined with other prostaglandins, it can lose its activity in reducing intraocular pressure. Redness of the eye is the main side effect observed. It can also produce some itching and irritation in the eye. This drug should be given as one drop once daily. Using this drug more than once is not recommended. So that's all about this medication. I hope this video is useful to you. If you really like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.